I'm here in Kenya, in Bungoma County, in Kambuchai constituency, and in Amuyemba village. I'm in the home of the Right Honorable Speaker, the third in command of the Kenyan government, and that is Right Honorable Speaker Masika Moses Wetangula. Since you live in the border community, yes. Do you have relatives across who live in Uganda?
Our clans are in both sides. My clan in particular, Wabutu, are also in Uganda. In fact, there are more in Uganda than in Kenya.
Actually, I'm a Mubutu.
So really? You're my relative. Yes.
My relative.
So we have those things. So I have a lot of relatives in Uganda. Some are even either sitting members or former members of parliament.
Okay.
My friend, my cousin Paul Wopua. George William Wopua was a member of parliament.
Okay.
And many others.
So you speak some Lugisu?
Yes.
No, he's a hova masaba bo. The Senator Bungoma told me how every county has received some money to plant trees, and that is a drive which has been fronted by the President, President Ruto. Are you doing it only as Kenya or there is something? Are there any steps you've made to integrate even the Ugandan government, the Rwandan government?
In Kenya we have a law, the Forest Act, that obligates everybody, including the government, to plant trees in the land that they own and they have title to. It has not been properly enforced in the past, but if you looked at the COP27 in Sharm el-Sheikh, Egypt, our president was the official spokesperson for the African continent on climate issues at COP27.
Yes.
He emphasized the need for Africa to resuscitate our environment through tree planting, protection of water catchment areas, protection of water bodies, protection of our rivers, and so on and so forth.
You've talked about having relatives across, and that brings me to the East African community. You've talked about integration, but many times we've asked for how many days we are going to spend in Kenya whenever we are crossing. When are these restrictions going to end? What are your plans to ensure that there's a complete integration of East Africa?
The process of re-engineering and strengthening and deepening the capacity of the East African community. I know that under the East African protocols, we have free movement of people, goods, and services. Under the protocol on immigration and movement of people, it has been agreed and signed to by all our heads of state. This was done when I was the foreign minister of Kenya, that Kenyans going to Uganda and vice versa, and indeed within the East African community, you don't even need your passport.
Yes.
You can cross the borders just by identifying yourself with your national identity card.
Yes.
I have traveled by air from Nairobi to Uganda using my ID. I've traveled by air from Nairobi to Dar es Salaam using my ID. And I believe that the problems we have are just enthusiastic workers at the border who are still tied to the past, where people, instead of being facilitated to travel, are prevented from traveling, as President Seven has been saying. We want to urge, and I'll take this opportunity to urge, all immigration officers and the related personnel who man our border points across East Africa, that their duty is to facilitate the free movement of people, goods, and services, and not to prevent those movements, so that East Africans can enjoy the fruits and benefits of integration. I have also said, and I want to continue advocating for, a future situation where members of the East African Parliament are not elected by their respective national parliaments, but elected by the people of East Africa.